All right, so we'll get on the phone line right now and speak to Jacob Osei Yabua. If you remember him very well, he contested as an independent candidate in the 2012 and also 2016 elections, even though he survived the disqualification of the Electoral Commission. He's still around contesting for presidential office. We'll be speaking to him soon. But right now, though, we have Muhammad Ayariga on the line. He is Hassan Ayariga, rather. And we'll be speaking to him about this new amount that the Electoral Commission has put out there as the one that political parties and presidential candidates have to pay in order to be eligible to stand for the 2020 general elections. So, good evening, Hassan Ayariga, and thank you for agreeing to speak to us. Hello, Hassan Ayariga, are you there?
Yeah, can you hear me? Good evening.
Good evening, sir. I can hear you.
Thank you.
Right, so we all know the issue now that has been put up by the Electoral Commission. What is your first take on the 100,000 cedis that the Electoral Commission has put out as the amount that political parties have to pay in order to contest for the 2020 elections?
For me, I think that I'm trying hard to believe the reason why there has been an increment of 100% of the filing fee of the presidential candidate. I'm trying to figure out the intent or the reason behind why the Electoral Commission will increase filing fees of presidential candidates to 100,000 without consultation with the IPAC, none with the advisory committee eminent committee of the EC. I'm beginning to understand that really my issue of strong institutions in this country is still not working. I have been campaigning very hard for strong institutions. And this institution has demonstrated to us that it's a weak institution, because you just don't get up from one election to another, increase a filing fee over 100%. And you expect the ordinary Ghanaian whose salary is less than 5,000 Ghana cedis a month to be able to raise an amount of 100,000 cedis to contest for a presidential election. What it means to me is that our multi-party participation is not being encouraged. It's rather being discouraged, because as EC and a body, the purpose of EC is to increase multi-party participation. And this has not been the case in this region. So for me, I think that democracy is for sale. Democracy is not about competent leaders anymore. It's not about ordinary Ghanaians who can lead and who have the best brains to lead anymore. It's about those who have money and they can afford to run a campaign or contest for a presidential election. They are then given the opportunity to run for election.
Great.